Happy Monday. Coming to you live from, I don't know, you email me and let me know where you think I am. First off, I just want to thank you for last week sending all those kind words on Padlet. I could barely make it through reading them just without the rush of emotion remembering being with you guys. So today I want to start with the Word of God. I'm going to come up closer. Can you see this? Is it covering the whole screen? All right. It says, estén siempre alegres, oren sin cesar, den gracias a Dios en toda situación, porque esta es su voluntad para ustedes en Cristo. Be happy always. Oh, yes, en Cristo Jesús. Excuse me. Oren sin cesar, pray without ceasing, den gracias. Those are ustedes' commands. Give thanks to God en toda situación, in every situation, porque esta es su voluntad. That's his will for you guys in Christ Jesus. That's our verse today. Now we're going to the verb of the day. You guys can now sketch this down on your notebook paper. Our verb of the day is to get along. Remember this chapter on page 409. You're reading that once each day and you're seeing how to get along with people. Llevarse bien or not getting along so well. Llevarse mal. I just put it in the present tense. Me llevo. I get along. Like, me llevo con mi esposa. Es su cumpleaños. Te llevas. Do you get along? Se lleva. He gets along. Nos llevamos. We get along. Se llevan. They get along. Now I want to review with you a couple things that I taught you last week. The first off is the possessives. Remember, we're studying family members, and I think we got a quiz coming up on miércoles, so make sure you know your family members. But here we go. My is me, yours is tú, his is su or hers, nuestro, su, and sus for y'all's and theirs. For example, I would say, this is my wife, es mi esposa. It's not going to be mis, because I only have one wife. But I want to say, mis papeles, my papers, because there are several papers. And then if you want to say, y'all's teacher, su profesor, because there's just one teacher. Then I also taught you the long forms. The long forms are very similar, and my papers are stuck. The long forms are very similar, except for they are un poco más largo. And there it is. All right. So just like, you know, mamma mia, my mother, mio is mine, or if it's something that I possess that is feminine. Remember, what is possessed is the key to know if it's mio, mia, mios, mias. Tuyo is yours. Suyo is his or her or users. Nuestro, same as the short form. Suyo for y'all's, and suyo for theirs. So you see, 50% of the time, the answer is suyo, suya, suyo, suyas. For example, if I would say, hey, this homework, is this yours? I would say, es tuya, because it's tarea. And then you say, no, it's his. That would be es suya, right? That's the long form possessives. And those come in handy when we're studying families. Then, the other thing we studied last week was comparisons. Comparisons. You use más plus an adjective plus K. So I would say today is cooler than yesterday. I would say es más frío que ayer. Or menos plus adjective plus K. I would say es menos caliente que ayer. It is less hot than yesterday. But if two things are equal, you use tan plus an adjective plus como. So I want to say that pizza tastes as good as chicken. Es tan deliciosa como el pollo. Or if it's a noun and you want to say two things are equal, you would say tanto plus noun plus como. For example, I want to say, I have just as many pesos as you. Tengo tantos pesos como tú. Or tantas amigas. That would become feminine. And then verb plus más que, if I want to say, I eat more than you. Como más que tú. You eat less than me. Tú comes menos que yo. Or if a verb just as much, like she studies as much as her sister, verb, ella estudia tanto como su hermana. Don't forget the irregulars. If somebody's older, it's mayor. If somebody is younger, they're menor, like a minor, and like the mayor of the town. And then if somebody is better, it's mejor, and somebody is worse, it's peor. Like, you'd want to say something like, algebra, my grade in algebra is worse than my grade in history. Mi nota en álgebra es peor que. So those are, to say something is worse.
Like poor.
Poor. Yes, peor is poor. I have a poorer grade. That's a good way to remember it. And yes, I do have a camera help today. It's been very, very helpful. All right, now I want you to grab your textbook and we're going to go over these comparisons a little bit. And if you would open your text, I'm looking at the right class, to 396. I'm going to grab my book. All right, so activity 6 on 396, Mi Familia. Today I just want you to scratch these down on a scrapbook paper. You do not need to email these to me today, but you do need to either say them out loud or write them down. Habla de las características de los miembros de tu familia. Talk about the characteristics of the people in your family. ¿Cómo se comparan? For example, in the model it says, my grandparents are as patient as my parents. Mis abuelos son tan pacientes como mis padres. Or, my cousin is funnier than I am. Mi prima es más cómica que yo. So, look at those adjectives. Generoso. Can you think of somebody in your family that's generous? All right? I'm going to say my dad. So I'm going to say my dad is more generous than my mom. Mi papá es más generoso que mi mamá. Now you, say somebody who's generous in your family. Either they're as generous or more generous or less generous. Next one, impatient. Can you think of anybody who's impatient? All right, maybe you want to say your aunt. So I would say mi tía es más impaciente que mi mamá. Come up with somebody impatient in your family. All right, now, orgulloso, prideful, proud. Well, I would say grandpa is pretty proud of the family. Mi abuelo es más orgulloso que yo. Paciente. Can you think of somebody who's patient? All right. How about somebody who's just as patient as somebody else? Like, you want to say, mi hermana es tan paciente como su abuelo. Okay. Artístico. Anyone in your family artistic? Are they more artistic? So you want to say something like, Leah es más artística, remember she's a girl, que Thomas. Okay, popular. Anyone popular in your family? Go ahead and say the similar thing. All right, how about sincere? Do you have a sincere person in your family? I want to say that my aunt is as sincere as my uncle. Mi tía es tan, be careful, sincera como mi tío. Shy. Any shy people, quiet people in your family? Yeah, absolutely. You want to say, Richard es tan tímido como Jacob. Cómico. Any funny people in your family? All right. I want to say something like, my grandma is as funny as my uncle. Mi abuela es tan cómica como mi tío. All right, so you guys just write down some of those things or speak out some of those comparisons that you have. Now, we've got some Ciber Amigos. One more activity we're gonna do together today, and it's activity 7, Julio y Julia. Usen la información dada para comparar Julio y Julia. You're gonna compare these two people. So you see Julio, his age, how many brothers he has, how many animals he has, what he's like. He says, soy alto, sociable, impaciente. What does he like to do? He likes to correr, es atlético, arte, música, pero no sabe dibujar ni cantar. He doesn't know how to draw or sing very well, and he plays a little guitar. And then you have Julia, who is 16 años, has dos hermanos, one fish, two birds. You see, she's baja, she has pelo largo, long hair, she's tímida, but she is cómica. What does she like to do? She's artistic. She sings and draws. Her dad's a soccer coach. All right, now let's compare. Let's compare. I'm going to ask you a question and you answer, either jotting it down or speaking it out loud. Look at the model. It says, ¿Quién dibuja mejor? Who draws better? Well, the answer in the model is, Julia dibuja mejor que Julio. She draws better than Julio. All right, ¿Quién tiene más pájaros? Who has more birds? All right, I see that Julia has just as many birds as Julio. So I would say Julia tiene tantos pájaros como Julio. Number 2, who's more athletic? Well, the guy said he's athletic and the girl said she's not. So Julio es más atlético que Julia. Peces, who has more fish? Julio tiene más peces. I see the camera's swimming. Que Julia. Who's more sociable? Looks like Julia is not. She's shy. So I would say Julia es menos sociable, or Julio es más sociable que Julio. Remember the más plus adjective plus que.
Rather is the time.
Okay. Looks like I gotta get going here. Who is taller? Goodness. Yeah, I don't see who's taller. I'm gonna guess the guy that's pretty normal for the guy to be taller. Julio es más alto. But if by some chance, Julia es más alta que Julio. All right, who sings better? Well, Julia said she can sing well, so Julia canta mejor que Julio. Who is older? Well, Julia is older. You ready? Julia es mayor que Julio. Or I could say Julio, number 8, is younger. Es menor que Julia. All right, be practicing these comparisons, and tomorrow you're going to turn in your score. I will give you the answers for page 321, 322, and then be studying your vocab on 409 for the quiz on family and relationships. That's two sections on 409. That'll be on Wednesday. All right, later on, from the woods. All right, so I want to do this continuation. We're in the text on 397, and I'm just going to do this nota gramatical. It says to compare numbers, más and menos, use de instead of que. So, for example, if you want to say Susan has more than 10 fish, you say Susana tiene más de 10 peces. Or, the bird costs less than 500 pesos. El pájaro cuesta menos de 500 pesos. Well, all I'm saying, instead of saying más que, when you have a number, you just switch the K to a de. Más de. So I'm in my basement right now, and I was just going to show you a few things and make some statements. I'd like you to practice this as well in your house somewhere. You see, this activity here is based on your backpack. And what we would normally do is I'd have the students get in partners and get their backpack and say, I have more than 2 pencils, tengo más de 2 lápices, etc. So I'm just going to do the activity with me, you imagine in your own house, like, oh, in this room I have more than 5 books. Tengo más de 5 libros. So we're gonna go around in my bed. I know it's a workshop, but it's also a food storage place. So I see these things. This is called cereal, and it looks like yo tengo más de 9 cereales. I have more than 9 cereals because I have 10. Tengo 10. Or wait, tengo más de 10 cereales. But actually, with cans, it looks like we have menos de 20 latas. We have fewer than 20 cans. And then as we're moving around. Oh, papel de baño. I would say tengo más de 10. I got more than 10. How about tissues? Tengo más de 6. Tengo menos de 100. I have less than 100. And then, I mean, this is a basement. It's a Michigan basement. You can see part of my Amazon business here. Tengo más de 100 libros. I have more than 100 books. Yeah, many, many more. Muchos más de 100. You see, when you're saying a number, it's más de 100. But I have menos de 3 millones. I have less than 3,000. See, let's see, a little potty humor. ¿Cuántos pupus? Menos de un pupú. Yes. What about comida de gato? Oh, tengo más de 2 comidas de gato. All right. Anyway, this short lesson was basically just to teach you how to say more than when it's coming with a number. It's más de. If it's with an adjective or a noun, you say más que. Signing out from Goshen, Indiana.